Hey guys, how you are doing? I hope you are doing really well and welcome to Artistic Goals. So today we all are reviewing these, the Camlin watercolor brush paints. I have already taken out them from the package. The package basically opens from the side. And then this tray comes out, and as you can see, we have so many varieties. There are 24 shades in this big pack, but you can also get these in three different sizes. And these are the shades which comes in this 24 shades pack, which is of 350 rupees. And today I will be showing you how to use this these paints in many different styles, for drawing, for calligraphy, etc. And I will be also sharing some tips and tricks for it. So let's get into it. I made this doodle, like mandala type of thing, to test out those markers, and I'm really excited. I just made it in 2 or 3 minutes, so it's not the best thing I can do. But yeah, I am really excited.
So this is not the final drawing which I am doing for this review. This is just one test. I didn't want to just watch it again. That's why I did this doodle. And because of this doodle, I understood that these paints are really nice. The ink flow is really good. Then brush nets are really high quality. And you can get smaller details, as well as you can fill the larger areas easily with these brush pens.
After all, in this easy first attempt, nothing irritated me about these pens, and I would say it was a really relaxing experience doing this little doodle. And yes, I was inspired to do more things with these pens after this first attempt at drawing with watercolor brush pens from Camlin. Right now we saw how these work with paper, and they can cover really nice area with color. So I want to test them for calligraphy, because I know there are so many people who love calligraphy and want to have some nice brush pens. So I'm going to check these pens for calligraphy. Doing calligraphy, I got to know that I can have really smaller and thinner strokes with these pens, as well as thicker and bolder strokes really easily. With my basic calligraphy knowledge, I think these pens are really nice for doing calligraphy.
Okay, so that we have already did 2 mini doodles of seeing how these paints are, I want to share my thoughts on the shades in the pack. So we have 24 shades in this pack, and I think some of them are really unexpected colors to me, like this yellow and this orange. Those are almost like highlighters. So I don't know how many people use those kinds of colors in their drawings. There might be people who use it, but personally I have a really minimum use of these. And interestingly enough, there are 2 gray colors, and one is like lighter one and other one is darker one. So these 2 are grays. That is really interesting, and I feel like it is really useful to have gray tones in the like shades or paints. And my really favorite one, this is pink. This is also kind of neon highlighty, but it is not as bright as these two. I really like this pink color. And we have quite a variety of greens and blues as well. And the really unique color I thought in the pack was this one, the maroonish color. This one right here, that is really unique color, and I think it is gonna be useful for like hair and maybe pants when we are coloring the drawing. Even though these are just like flat colors. There is ochre color, so that's really good. There is also a dark olive green, this one, which is also really nice. I think the overall color range is really vast, and I feel like these are enough for like basic drawings. I would really want two different colors rather than these two, but it's okay, we can adjust with it. And yeah, the most important thing I found was there were skin colors. I was not expecting to get skin color. I know this is really vibrant color, but we can tone it down to use as a skin color. So yeah, that is impressive to me. I have done these two doodles and I am pretty satisfied with the result, the pigment and the ink flow, also the brush nib. I am really impressed and I am so excited to get on to the main drawing part now.
Now I am moving on to the main drawing part where I'll give you tips and tricks about these paints. So stay tuned. The first tip I am going to give you is this. You can use them as watercolors. You just have to scribble them into your palette and then use your watercolor brush to pick up the pigment and use it as watercolors. Using these pens in this way gives you a little diluted color which makes it more natural. As you can see, the skin tone was a little brighter and I wanted to use it as the base color, which was faint. That's why I used this technique and it worked really well. I could get a natural and light skin tone which is not really bright, which helped me to do this portrait. Okay, so the second tip is about shading. For the shading, you can do it really easily by putting down the first color, then going over with second color and pulling it outwards, then going over with the third color you have to mix them all to get seamless blend. You will see me using this technique a lot during this video and also in the future, as it is really easy way to shade your drawing. But while doing this, this happened. So the blue colored marker dripped a drop of color onto the face and now she has a beauty spot. So this happened only once, but it was really irritating because on her faint face now there was a dark blue patch, but then I afterward fixed it. But it is worth mentioning that it is not a recurring problem. I came across this problem just once with only one marker. I am using the same technique which is tip 2 for the eyebrows, and I am going to do the same thing with the eyes. I put down the yellow color and then shaded it with ochreish color which I had in the marker set. And as you can see in the drawing, that I could get really fine point to draw her eyeliner with the same pen. And this is the indication that brush nibs are well made and high quality. Okay, now it's turn for tip 3. Here I am using a technique called cell shading. I basically put down the lightest color I had and now I am going over with darker colors to give it shadows and dimensions. As this pack has a lot of colors and different shades of same hue, it is possible to get a good cell shading experience. In this way, I could get highlights, mid-tones and darker tones using this pen. With that being said, let's have a tip 4. Here you have to put down the color you want and then use water to dilute it further.
This gives a seamless watercolor blend which you are looking for. Actually, this element was inspired by the packaging itself. Okay, now let's have a tip 5. Here you have to hold the tip of your darker markers on the lighter marker. In this way, you get a shading or darker to lighter effect really easily. You don't have to go over with 2 markers or 3 markers. You just have to hold a nib over other and then use it to give a lighter to darker or darker to lighter gradient. Here I have used 2 tips together by using gradient technique, like this tip and the other one where I used water to dilute it. Here is again a demonstration to use tip 5, and don't worry, this doesn't ruin your tips, because afterwards the darker color on the nib goes away by using the pen. Here you can see me mixing and matching all the tips I gave you till now. I am mixing colors by putting them down directly over each other, then diluting them with water. And you don't have to limit yourself to just one tip. Like this, you can use many tips together. Again, I am holding 2 tips together and getting a gradient effect. And as you can see, the skin color was really light color. And afterwards, the stain of ochreish color gone away when I used it. The same technique of holding nibs I am using here for her jewelry. I got a green to yellow gradient by using this technique. These markers are really easy to blend together, and they blend together really smoothly. You don't get any colored streaks, and the whole blend is really smooth and visually pleasing. Here I am showing you that yellow color is now free of green color. Here is my attempt at removing that blue spot from the face, but my white gel pen couldn't do it. So I broke out my trusty old whitener, and it worked like a charm.
Okay, so the main drawing part from the paints is done, and I loved the experience of doing the art with these paints, and I'll be sure using these in the future. But I have a question now. What should I do with background? Should I leave it white? Should I add other colors? Like, one way I want to add this blue color, but again it will clash here. Then I want to add yellow to balance out with this hair, but at bottom it won't match. I don't know what to do. So let's see, I might bust out my watercolors. Let me think. And I'll be back in a second for you, and in 2 minutes for me. Okay, so I have made my mind, and I will be doing bluish tones, to be specific, these 2 colors, but not as it is. I will be doing a technique I showed you with water. So yeah,
back to tip 1, scribble the blue pigment onto palette, and now I am adding the water to it to give the watercolor effect.
Okay, so our final drawing is ready, and I am more than happy to tell my thoughts about these paints. Okay, then about the quality of these paints, the ink quality, the brush tips, those are amazing. 10 out of 10 for the brush nib and ink flow, and vibrant colors are there, so I am really happy. So I would 10 out of 10 recommend these for the drawing experience. What about the individual marker rating?
I think their design of marker is really awesome. Like the cap fits at the end, like I always see people concerning about it, so I think that's the point. Again, the color is all over the body of that pen, so I think that's not a problem for me. The design of the pens, even for holding those for longer period of time, I find it really easy and really nice. So there also I would give 10 out of 10. For the packaging purposes, yeah, it is a cardboard box which opens from side, and they can upgrade their packaging a little bit, but again, I am the person who values the colors or the content inside, not the outside. It would have been nice if we got a more sturdy package, but yeah, I think I can adjust with it, and yeah, I would give 9 out of 10 for the packaging. Okay, other than that, would I recommend these to you? If you are a beginner, these are excellent for you. If you are an artist, then yeah, I think if you get creative with using these pens, these are incredible, and there is nothing negative about it. Yeah, there are one, two colors which could be swapped, but again, that's just my personal preference. And to be honest, I can see myself as beginner enjoying this. I can see myself right now enjoying this. So yeah, I would totally recommend these. And the most curious question is, are these the best brush pens? Okay, I have tried many brush pens, and I think these Camlin brush pens are really awesome. And yes, these are really best watercolor brush pens I have ever used, and I will 100% recommend these to you. I really hope that today's video helped you out, and also you enjoyed my artwork. I tried to get creative even when I was showing you different tips and tricks to use these kinds of pens. So I really hope you find a value out of it. If so, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Turn on that bell notification so that you don't miss out on any of my content. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next video. Bye.